I heard tale that on the set of this film, you spent the entire day in the basket of the getaway car.
Yeah, maybe day and a half.
Day and a half?
Yeah.
Was it comfortable? It doesn't look particularly comfortable.
They spent a lot of time and effort making it as comfortable as possible, which is pretty comfortable.
Gotcha. And would you drive around in it? Would Michael Caine drive you around, or would you just sort of just hang out there?
No, just, you know, when we do a shot, somebody else would have to take it back. I'm going to sit in there and just ride back.
Yeah. This movie has Michael Caine, Alan Arkin, mm-hmm. fantastic actor. You've worked with Michael Caine before. Have you worked with Alan Arkin before?
No.
Are there people left that you are excited to work with?
Oh, yes.
Really?
Yes. Oh, good grief,
if you could work with anyone you hadn't worked with, who would it be?
Anyone.
Oh, okay. So it's not a very high bar.
Well, Seth, it's not a good idea to start naming names.
That's true. I understand. That's why you're a beloved actor. You've never named names.
I don't name names.
Yeah.
I mean, I name the ones that I have worked with, but naming the ones that I want to work with and haven't worked with, if you start and you go about 3 or 4, and you say, oh, that's good, but then there may be 9 or 12 saying, what am I, chopped liver or something?
Yeah, there you go.
You know what I'm saying?
You're a lot smarter about this than I am. The director of this film, Zach Braff, I heard that you lost a bet to Zach, and the price of the bet was you had to record his outgoing voicemail.
Yes.
Is this... I would imagine that is a thing people ask you to do all the time.
Yes.
Are you amenable to it, or do you have to lose a bet in order to do it?
No. No.
Okay.
I have to lose a big bet now.
Okay. Because I would imagine it gets exhausting having to record
it. It gets exhausting, you know. I can't tell you how many times I've said, hello, this is so-and-so. It's not willing to come to the phone right now.
Yeah. You know, if you want me to record yours, I feel like you have one coming, you know, karmically. Because no one's ever asked me.
Well, I would, Seth, but, you know, I have the perfect, absolute perfect telephone answerer.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. The guy who installed the system was a Southerner with just the most god-awful Mississippi drawl you ever heard, who calls and says, hello, leave a number.
Is that true?
Yes, and he sounds about as far away from me as you can get.
And you just had him do it?
Well, he did it as a test, and I wouldn't change it. It's perfect.
So the one place you can't hear an outgoing voicemail from Morgan Freeman is on Morgan Freeman's phone.
Absolutely.
Well, there you go. There you go.
It really is. Because if you call there and you've never called before, you got the wrong number.
Oh, I see.
You see? Yeah, but he doesn't even say this is Morgan's phone or anything like that.
Yeah.
You know?
So, and because ideally, you don't want people leaving you messages. Is that safe to say?
Ideally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we're all that way.
Yeah. Well, I mean, particularly people I don't know.
Yeah, those would be the worst people.
Yeah, could be.
You got asked to do some voice work for somebody, Mark Zuckerberg, to be, what is it, his, like, virtual assistant? Is that an accurate way?
Sort of, yeah. this is a smart guy. So, he just... building something for his own fun, right? And so he's dabbling in artificial intelligence, and he made a character, there's a computer he calls Jarvis.
Jarvis, right.
And, you know, Jarvis wakes him up, makes coffee, opens blinds. Jarvis is the man Friday. So he asked me if I would be the voice. I said, sure.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a good one. That's a good person to say yes to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good friend to have.
Yeah, very good friend to have.
Mark.
It's crazy to think that there's someone who's so smart that can just, like, do that on the side.
Yeah, they're intimidating.
Yeah, people like that.
Yeah, he looks like he's about 22.
Yeah.
And that's too awesome
for
me.
We just baby-proofed my kitchen, and the other day I couldn't figure out how to open the drawer. That's where I'm at.
Don't child-proof anything around you. I mean, I have to have a child to open one of those caps and, you know, medicine.
Yeah.
So it's just childproof. You know, it's old folk proof.
Yeah. And you need to get the old people need to get their pills.